Today, I'm going to speak on the fixed term contract which is brought in by way of a notification by the central government, wherein it has allowed all the sectors to appoint employees, workmen on a fixed term. Now this has been legalized by way of a notification. To start with, as an introduction, I would prefer to take you to the background. Earlier, Contract Labour Regulation and Abolition Act 1970 was applicable for employment of contract labour. Contract labour is employed not only in private sectors, it is employed in public sectors, it is employed in government companies also and used by government. In fact, if we make an analysis of, if we take an index of the contract labor employed between private sectors and government, it is the government at the center and the various states which uses more of contract labor when compared to the private sectors. The Contract Labour Regulation and Abolition Act, along with other applicable laws related to the employment of contract labour, the sectors used to comply for employing contract labour. The establishments, the industries in private sectors, they were showing a concern about if we employ a contract workman for 240 days in the previous year, he will become a regular workman and we have to comply with all the statutory compliances, and there are possibilities that some of these contract labor may approach the labor department, the labor commissioner's office for providing a direction to the employer to consider him as a regular workman, and for other factors like payment of bonus and bringing him in parity with the other regular workmen, blah blah blah, many other reasons. Therefore, invariably what used to happen is the employers, they normally employ someone as a contract labor, but he will not be allowed to complete 240 days of service. There will be a discontinuity in his service, and after that he is again employed and he continues for some time without, to the employer ensures that he doesn't complete 240 days, and then there is a disconnection, and then again he is employed, you know, like that, to maneuver, to duck from the applicable enactments. Today, perhaps observing the trend across India, this enactment, Contract Labour Regulation and Abolition Act, was brought into, along with other 15 enactments in labour laws, including Factories Act, under one heading, called code on occupational safety, health and working conditions. Code on occupational health, safety, health and working conditions. Under this code, there are 16 enactments including contract labor regulation. What the government did is, first, before when they were envisaging for this code, incidentally, codification of labor laws, the government has attempted. In that, there are 4 codes which the government has envisaged, and among the 4 codes, 2 of them are already law, the other 2 has to be passed as law. These 4 codes are Code on Wages, Code on Industrial Relations, Code of Social Security, and the last one is the one which I am addressing, Code on Occupational Safety, Health and Working Conditions. Under these 4 codes, the 44-45 enactments what we see in labor laws are all from the 44. They are grouped into 4 codes and they are brought under each one of these codes. Now let me not delve into that, because that's a separate subject matter by itself. To do this, first, way back, Contract Labor Regulation and Abolition Act, a draft was made to repeal the enactment of this Act, 1970 Act, and to bring in new changes adaptable to the present waters, present situation. The government had given 60 days time, and from the chambers I had given our views, suggestions, objections, starting from the first section to the last repealing section, repealing the earlier enactment, 1970 enactment. Going deep into the draft notification and then what happened subsequently, how they have made the changes and how they have brought in those changes in this code on occupational safety, health and working conditions for contract workmen, let me not go too deep into that, because that by itself is a subject matter. These changes were made, and this code on occupational safety, health and working conditions, containing in the 16 enactments this contract labor related matter also with modifications, were announced by way of draft notification way back in January this year. And subsequently, after receiving the government, in fact, awaited receiving inputs of the views, expressions, objections from the affected parties, but having not received much, they extended the time from 2 months. They added 1 more month and said, please provide us the views and objections on this codification. In this, now this is not yet an enactment. The government has received the objections and they are yet to enact, they are yet to turn this code into a law. It has to pass in the parliament. Coming back retouching on this notification related to fixed term contract, the government did not wait for this code to be passed as a law in the parliament, but in the meantime the government has passed an official notification in March 2018, allowing the sectors, all the sectors, to employ contract labor on fixed term contract. See, the apprehension that an employee, a workman who has worked in the previous year for 240 days has to be considered as a regular workman, the apprehension that he will move the courts of law to consider him in parity with the regular workmen, all that has been considered in this notification by way of an amendment to the standing orders. Now I am going to take you through the notification as such, what it contains, how it helps, are there any concerns related to this also to the employer. Now about the notification. The Ministry of Labour and Employment wide notification dated 16th March 2018 has notified the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Central Amendment Rules 2018. What it has done is, it amends the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Central Rules, hitherto applicable, Central Rules of 1946, hitherto applicable. But I'll tell you, it has brought in, this notification has brought in a significant labor reform, allowing fixed term employment across all sectors. In fact, it had released a draft notification on this also, seeking inputs in the form of views, objections on 8th January 2018 and subsequently, I will call it as hurriedly, in March they have notified this. Hurriedly, I don't know why. But they have notified this and now today it is a law. There is no difference between the contents of the draft notification and the contents of the gazetted, officially gazetted notification. However, the ministry has clarified that no existing permanent employee or employees can be converted to fixed term employee or employees. After all, it is a social legislation what we are talking about, and it is the bounden duty not only of the government, of the employer also, to protect the employees. And hence the ministry has said, look, with this notification having come into force, the employer cannot utilize this notification to convert the existing permanent regular employees into fixed term employment employees. What I mean is providing them fixed term employment for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. That is not possible. The next highlight is Earlier, fixed term employment as such was a practice in apparel industries, apparel manufacturing sector as such, which was allowed only in that. No other sector was allowed for fixed term employment of contract labor employees. Now, with this fixed term employment being notified, in the notification it is officially allowed, extended to all the sectors, which means any sector can employ contract labor, contract employees for a fixed term. The next highlight is the notification is prospective in nature, with a clarification that the employers cannot convert the permanent workmen into fixed term contract. They cannot do that. Now, what does it mean by fixed term employment workman? It has introduced in the rules, it says the term fixed term employment workman means a workman who has been engaged on the basis of a written contract of employment for a fixed period. This means contract employees, contract labor can be hired by all the sectors, fixing the period of contract, but it should be in writing. It is a condition precedent. Two condition precedents with rider clauses, which I am going to explain, that there should be a written contract and it should be for a fixed period. What it means is, you bring in a group of employees, provide them in writing, look here, this is your contract and this is for a term 1, 2, 3 years, starting from, with effect from such and such a date to such and such a date. It means on the arrow of time of the period, by flux of time, the contract terminates. There is a termini fixed on the close of office hours of the last day fixed in this contract. This is what it means. Now, while defining so in the rules, it also says, provided that A, his hours of work, wages, allowances and other benefits shall not be less than that of a permanent workman. What it means is, you have certain regular workmen working on the floor or elsewhere doing certain kind of jobs. Job type A, job type B, blah blah blah. Suppose you bring in a workman, an employee for a fixed term on type A. Workmen are doing particular kind of job. There is a job description to that. You bring in 1 or 10 contract workmen for a fixed period doing that type A job. You cannot bring a disparity between your regular workmen and the contract workmen whom you employ for a fixed period related to the hours of work, related to the wages, related to whatever allowances you are giving and other benefits. This fixed term contract employees, workmen should not be deprived of all this. This is the first rider. The second, he shall be eligible for all statutory benefits available to a permanent workman proportionately according to the period of service rendered by him. Even if his period of employment does not extend to the qualifying period of employment required in the statute as per the standing order rules. What this means? All the statutory benefits, whatever the permanent workman you have, should be extended to these contract workmen who work on who work for a fixed period equally. You cannot make your contract workman providing him more and this workman less. But of course, it depends on the number of years of service. For example, if the regular workman you have has 5 years of service doing type A job, and the contract workman you are bringing in has zero experience or maybe 1 or 2 years of experience, I understand, the statute understands, to proportionately there is that disparity, his salary being higher, his statutory benefits being higher, and this man getting the salary at a lower wages is allowed. You cannot, the law doesn't say that you have 5 year experienced workman here and you bring with zero experience or 3 years of experience, pay them the same salary. It doesn't say so. This is another rider clause. Another highlight which the notification has brought is, the notification actually in the form of amendment to the provisions in the Industrial Employment Standing Order Central Rules 1946 clarify that no notice of termination of employment is required in the case of temporary workman. Who are all the temporary workmen? Whether he be monthly rated, weekly rated or piece rated, and probationers, it also includes badli workmen. This classification of temporary workmen need not be provided with a notice of termination. This is one. The second one. Further, even the fixed term workman is not entitled for any kind of termination notice when the employer wishes not to renew his fixed term contract. It also says the services of a temporary workman shall not be terminated as a punishment unless he has been given an opportunity of explaining the charges of misconduct alleged against him. That means, in a way, regular workmen, when you terminate them, you follow the procedure of issuing a show cause charge sheet cum show cause notice, conducting an unbiased inquiry, and based on the inquiry findings, if the charges are proved, you can terminate his service. Similar procedure has to be adopted in case an employer is terminating a temporary workman on as a punishment on grounds of charges of misconduct. Further, the notice requirements in all other sectors, there is no notice requirement, what just now I have explained. Whereas the notification has introduced, notice has to be provided for temporary workmen working in coal mines. At the moment, we need not touch on that. Now, let me conclude on this briefly with my comments. This move is a significant move, no doubt, to enable industries of belonging to various sectors, whether seasonal or otherwise, to utilize to hire workers on assignments required in their various projects. See, there are instances where you may use employees based on the tenure of your project. You can hire employees, workers, based on the tenure of a project. For example, a construction project, constructing a metro at Bangalore, some other place, you can hire them for a fixed period based on the tenure of your project. This is an advantage. Similarly, in seasonal industries like sugar manufacturing industries, just to give an example, they are of seasonal nature for specified months. It's not that they were not hiring for that period. The notification has legalized, that is all. In the seasonal industry, for that period, the employer can employ workmen, employees, specified to the tenure of that season. And once the season is over, once the project comes to an end, the assignment given to the workman, given to the employee, can be terminated. Fixed term workers have to be considered in parity with the regular workers based on their experience, based on their experience. And they are eligible for all statutory benefits available to a permanent worker proportionately according to the period of service rendered by them, I mean the fixed term workers. If I read out the rider clause, there is some ambiguity here. It says while saying that statutory benefits have to be extended, blah blah blah, it says even though their period of employment does not extend to the qualifying period of employment required in the statute. I will touch on that little later in the conclusion. As I said, the statutory benefits, the wages, have to be in parity with the regular workmen based on the number of years of service, the contract labor, the contract employee who has come for a fixed period has brought it. next. The conditions of service, the conditions of work, like the hours of work, wages, allowances, etc., should be in parity with the regular workman. The fixed term contractors, contract workmen's wages, allowances, number of hours of work should be in parity with the regular workman. Since the notification is prospective in nature, it clarifies that the employer, using as on the date of this notification, using this notification, cannot convert on as on the date of the notification the regular workman, the permanent workman, into fixed term employment. Additional advantage to the employers of all sectors which this notification provides is, the employers hitherto normally what they do, they hire a contractor and the contractor brings in the workman. With this notification, the employer can dispense with the contractor. There is no need for a middleman, an agent. There is no need for a middleman, an agent, and the employer can directly employ contract labor, contract employees for a fixed term. This is a great advantage for all the employers because of two factors. One, major factors I'm talking about, there are other factors also. One, the commission what you pay on the total wages which the contractor pays to the number of workmen which he has brought into your site, this commission is saved. The second, you have to ensure that the contractor complies with all the applicable laws under the sun, applicable to your sector, to your industry, under the industrial and labor laws. Otherwise, as a principal employer, you are held responsible as time advances when the enforcement officers under various enactments of labor laws approach your gate. Now, you can relax on that. There is no need for employment through an agency. It has its own disadvantages also, but what I mean by disadvantage, okay, what I mean by disadvantage is, this statute, this notification which is brought by the government, if I read this, taking into the repealment of the Contract Labour Regulation and Abolition Act of 1970, the modifications, the changes made in the new enactment by way of the code, as I told you in the beginning, among the 16 labor laws, contract labor regulation is also part of it. If I read this and that, there, as far as the compliances are concerned, as far as employment is concerned, the government is looking towards just, see, the contract laborers are just one or two pedestal below regular workmen. What I mean by this is, they are almost in parity with regular workmen if you read this notification with the draft code. If that is turned into a law, the code, the draft code turns into a law, and then this and that gets merged, the interpretations may vary, but I'm somehow uncomfortable if the employer, principal employer, utilizing this notification starts employing contract labor for a long term by his own way, by his own means, it may jeopardize his interests. How it does and all is itself a subject matter which I am not going to touch, but this I am apprehending. My apprehension may not be true also, I need to relook into it, but you as employers try to consult your consultants, legal consultants, the advocates who are advising you on this front. There is some ambiguity here, there is some apprehension I have. Now, to touch on the ambiguity which I mentioned, there appears to be some degree of ambiguity in the language of the notification that tends to recognize the fixed term of an employee for a tenure-based statutory benefits. I prefer to say that the ministry's intention is to cover statutory benefits, for example like gratuity, so that these fixed term contract employees, workmen, are not deprived of such benefits. However, if I take, say, Payment of Gratuity Act, earlier the requirement was that a workman should have completed continuous service of 5 years to be eligible for gratuity. Now, by way of a notification, that has been reduced to 3 years. That itself is a subject matter to be addressed, because the Payment of Gratuity Act, its purpose, the purpose of the enactment is different, and by way of notification, reducing the eligibility criteria from completion of 5 years to 3 years, it is against the purpose of the enactment. However, to touch base on the existing topic of fixed term contract, there is an ambiguity here. Perhaps the ministry's intention is to cover the benefits what the employer extends, statutory benefits to regular workmen, to be extended to fixed term workers. They are not deprived of tenure based statutory benefits. That may be the intention, but as I said, since the enactment is prospective in nature and it stresses on tenure based fixed term contracts, tenure based statutory benefits, there is some kind of ambiguity. If you take up Provident Fund, gratuity, eligibility criteria vis-a-vis the prospective nature, the rider clauses of this notification, I understand these amendments are required for the development of the nation, development of the working class, but there should be clarity on what it really means, giving room for interpretations. I think this notification requires clarification by the ministry by way of a circular at least. However, overall, this is a beneficial legislation both to the worker as well as to the employer. There is a significant change it is trying to bring in terms of employer-employee relationship, which is good, because it is a reform by itself, a labor reform. I think the employers can utilize this to begin with, at least for the projects on hand, for an experimental period of say 1 to 3 years. And then let us see, because there is 2019 upcoming election, based on whichever government comes, what other changes that will be brought in, we do not know. So let's not experiment. My advice to the employers is, don't stretch beyond 3 years fixed term contract. Let us see, 1 to 3 years, keep it as the ideal period. Later, based on the changes at the center, let us see how this can be utilized. Thank you.